I was just like every other farm kid. I didn't worry about getting dirty or bruised. I took responsibility seriously, and I learned how to care for my livestock and other chores. I'm a 5-generation farmer, with 4 generations of sheep farming on one side of my family, and 3 generations of beef farmers on the other side, along with other livestock and crops. On my first birthday, my parents gave me a ewe lamb, born closest to my birthday. For the next 13 years, they continued that tradition, with those sheep becoming the base of my own flock. At the age of 5, I chose the self-down sheep to be my breed. And even at an early age, I have shocked self-down breeders by continually picking out top quality animals without any help from my parents. But it was when I was 10 that I would discover the breed I would truly make my mark with, the Dorpers. Dorper sheep originated in South Africa in the 1950s, but were brought here to Canada in the 1990s. I was introduced to what would become my breed through one of my parents' sheep-shearing customers. I was immediately drawn to the sharp black and white contrast of the breed, but when I learned the long list of advantages, such as natural breeding out of season, fast rate of gain, great mothering skills, and the potential to produce a 60 to 70% carcass yield, I was sold. I bought a couple of ewes, and by the time that I sold their lambs, I was hooked. Where I've actually started to make a difference within the breed is through the genetics. I noticed early on that there's a certain genetic line that caused problems, resulting in poor mothering skills, slow rate of gain, and problems at lambing time. By selecting lambs to keep as breeding stock that had a minimal amount of this bloodline in them, I was slowly able to restructure the genetics within my Dorpers. Until today, I have less than 5% of that gene within my flock. Over the past 10 years, I've built a solid reputation for myself with my Dorpers, both purebred and commercial animals. Customers always seem surprised at the high standard that I hold my sheep to, never selling anything that isn't my best. My theory is that if I wouldn't bring it into my own flock, I'm not going to sell it to anybody else. You know that you have a good reputation when you always have repeat customers and when your new customers are brought in by word of mouth. In recent years, I've also brought in Leicester Longwool sheep to my flock, helping me to keep balanced in 2 aspects of the sheep industry, both meat and wool. Here at the Royal in 2010, I'd actually won Champion Longwool Ewe in the TD Junior Sheep Show. The Leicesters don't make me as much profit as my Dorpers, but they're a good secondary breed and do well for the 4-H members that I lend lambs to. Speaking of 4-H, that brings me into one of my other success stories. I've been a 4-H member since I was 10 years old, with both my parents being 4-H leaders, and currently have completed 80 club credits. I lend many of my lambs to 4-H members who don't have sheep of their own, and I'm able to promote my stock through those members. It's a win-win, because when the members do well for themselves, other breeders and potential customers can see the quality of animal that I'm producing. In fact, here at the Royal in 2012, 3 of my Dorpers made the top 5 of any other breed class in the Junior Sheep Show. As I always say, it's the quality that counts. As I mentioned at the start, I have both sheep and beef in my background. And although my family hasn't raised beef animals since I was young, this year I got back to my roots by joining a 4-H beef club. I was able to incorporate skills that I had grown up listening to my parents talk about, which truly paid off come show season, when I did very well in all of my classes. It also helped me to draw up a plan for myself for how I can start my own beef herd up in a few years, balancing markets, feed costs, and the breeds that will be best suited for me. Although I am waiting a couple of years to get in to the beef industry because of the price of beef. As many farmers do, I need a second job to try and fund my farming operation. Thankfully, I've been able to start my own business of horse training and lessons, competing in barrel racing and team penning. I also combine a self-employed business of graphic design and marketing, along with taking online courses in communications. As everyone knows, no matter how successful a business is, they will have problems along the way, and my farming operation is no exception. Between high feed costs, down markets, long winters, and unpredictable summers, and coyote problems, there's been years where it's been difficult to break even. But in true farmer fashion, I've taken my bumps in the field in stride, and I've come out on top. From past to present to future, my life has revolved around agriculture. It's helped teach me the skills that I will need to succeed in future endeavors, and it's helped me make the contacts I will need to succeed in the sheep industry. In 1 week from today, hopefully, I'll be holding my lamb and proudly showing our champion ribbon for all of my efforts. But even if all of the success I've had so far is as much as I get, that's okay, because, hey, it's in my genes, and that's my success story. Thank you.